Greetings, friends. The Torah warns us not to go after our hearts and our eyes. Rather, we are to look at the tzitzis. But we have to know the Torah is not telling us to ignore our heart. Just the opposite. HaKadosh Baruch Hu libaboi, Hashem desires the heart. Hashem does not want us to ignore our heart, but rather to elevate it by subjugating the desires and thoughts of the heart to His service. The other nations do not understand this, and for that reason, their hearts are filled with violence and hatred. But we are different. This week, we meet our father Abraham, Avraham Avinu. Our father Abraham elevated service of the heart, so it became the foundation of the world. Quote, Sefer Devarim, only your forefathers did Hashem cherish to love them, and He chose their offspring after them. You, from among all the peoples to this day, you shall cut away the barrier of your heart and no longer stiffen your neck. What did Hashem see in Avraham Avinu? Hashem selected Avraham, brought him out of Ur Kasdim, and made his name Avraham. I'm sorry, the text says Hashem selected Avram, brought him out of Ur Kasdim, and made his name Avraham. He found his heart faithful and sealed the covenant with him. Hashem made a covenant with our father Avraham because his heart was faithful. The Ari HaKadosh says, every morning before he starts praying, every Jew must say, I am taking upon myself as a mitzvah, I say a positive mitzvah, to love every Jew as I love myself. Indeed, there is a mitzvah to love every Jew as yourself, about which Rabbi Akiva said, this is a great principle of the Torah. I knew a Yid named Amos Bunim, may he rest in peace. He cried aloud during every davening, Mairif, Shachris, Mincha. He felt the words in his heart. He knew that he was davening for his life. We don't even realize the dangers that surround us. I once heard Rabbi Matisyahu Solomon Shlita say that if a Jew returns from the streets alive, it's a major miracle. Hashem is saving our lives every minute, and we don't realize. Every time we say the bracha Asha Yatzar, we're acknowledging that Hashem saved our life. Every time we make a bracha on food, we're acknowledging that Hashem is keeping us alive. Quote, anyone who does not mourn for Yerushalayim will not witness her joy at the time of the redemption. Avraham Avinu was the paragon of Chesed, and Chesed cannot exist unless one feels for another Jew. Olam Chesed Yibaneh, the world is built on kindness. I believe that if we don't feel the words, our davening is deficient. If we survive this tumultuous path to Mashiach that the world is on now, it will only be because we have cried out to the Master of the Universe to save us, the way our ancestors cried out in Mitzrayim in ancient Egypt. The greatest men in history knew how to cry. Here's a quote. Ben Yosef wanted to weep, so he went into the room and wept there. David HaMelech said, every night I drench my bed, with tears I soak my couch. And he also said, Al Naros Bavel, by the rivers of Bavel, by the rivers of Babylon, there we sat and wept when we remembered Tzion. Even though the gates of prayer have been locked, the gates of tears have not been locked. If our tefillos, our prayers, are not getting through, maybe it is because we have forgotten how to cry. Please forgive me, my friends, that I see people rush through davening so they can open a sefer. But why do they rush through davening? Hashem wants the heart. Hashem said to Shmuel HaNavi, do not look at his appearance or at his tall stature, for I have rejected him. For it is not as man sees. Man sees what his eyes behold, but Hashem sees into the heart. Hashem is waiting for us to serve him b'chol levavcha, with all our heart, as our father Abraham served him. And through Abraham, every bracha entered the world. Good Shabbos.